Professor Dave here. Let's prove the Pythagorean Theorem.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
As I mentioned before, when we initially learned the Pythagorean Theorem, there are very elegant ways to prove that the theorem is true. And now that we know how to calculate area, we are ready to perform one such proof ourselves. Let's say we draw a right triangle like this one and label the sides A, B, and C, like we are used to. Now let's make three more copies of this triangle and arrange them like this so that we get two squares. The larger square has a side length of A plus B, while the smaller inner square has a side length of C. We can calculate the areas of all of these shapes. We know that the area of one of the triangles will be 1/2 base times height, or 1/2 A times B. The area of the large square will be the side length squared, or A plus B quantity squared. And the small square will have an area of C squared. Now let's set up a relationship between these areas. The area of the large square is equal to A plus B quantity squared, as we just said, but it is also equal to the area of the small square plus the area of all the triangles, since these shapes comprise the larger square. So we can make an equation that states the following: A plus B quantity squared, the area of the big square, is equal to 4 times 1/2 AB, which is 4 times the area of one triangle, since there are four triangles, plus C squared, the area of the small square. We know how to square a binomial by using the FOIL method, so let's take away the exponent and just write the binomial out twice. First gives us A squared, outer gives us AB, inner gives us AB, and last gives us B squared. Combining like terms, that's A squared plus 2AB plus B squared. On the right, we can multiply 4 and 1/2, and we get 2AB plus C squared. As it happens, we have 2AB on both sides, so those will cancel out. And wouldn't you know it, take a look at what we are left with: the Pythagorean Theorem. I hope this result makes you feel warm and fuzzy inside, because proofs like this are what math is really all about. There are many other proofs of this theorem that involve similar calculations with triangles and squares and other shapes, so if you're just dying to know them all, it's time to hit the internet. Otherwise, let's move forward and wrap things up with geometry. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.